Hello everyone and welcome to Night Graphics. We have started discussing the chapter of transforming objects, and till now we have discussed two types of transforming, which are moving and rotating the objects. And in this video we will discuss about reflect. This function is a combination of flipping and rotating. Let's check out its available options. First of all, select the object you want to reflect. Then select the reflect tool from the tools panel. It is grouped with the rotate tool, and you have to long press the rotate button to view the reflect tool grouped here. As you will select this tool, you will see a mark right in the center of the selected shape. For a while, you may think that this point does not seem to be the center point of this shape, and actually it's not. Illustrator assumes the center point of any shape by drawing a four-sided bounding box around the shape, and then it finds the center of that bounding box. Usually while drawing, you may or may not like to view the bounding box around every shape you draw. However, if you like to view it, you can activate it by going to the View menu, and there you have the option of Show Bounding Box. Bounding box is shown when you activate the black arrow tool. Since we have Reflect tool selected, the bounding box is not shown around the selected shape. Here I select the black arrow tool, and now the bounding box has appeared. Now if you look at this box, the center seems to be here, which may not seem the center of this shape itself. Personally, I feel uncomfortable with bounding box, so I will turn it off, and we will now get back to the reflect tool. So my shape is selected, and I will double click on this tool to open its dialog box. This mark will act as a reference point from where the selected shape will be flipped or reflected. Here we have two straight options of flipping horizontally and vertically, or if you like, you can set the angle value of the reflection by entering the value here. Let's do some practical example to make this thing clear. This time I will choose this point as point of reflection, and if I want to open the dialog box in respect to this reflection point, I have to press Alt key and then click here. Let's flip it vertical, and I will press copy button, and notice that reflection was copied referring to this point. Now I will select both these shapes and then Alt click here to make this reference point. Now we'll flip horizontal and press copy, and notice that reflection of both these shapes is created with respect to this reference point. Let me show you another example of its implication. I have drawn here half of Batman's sign, and to draw the other side, I will simply use the reflect tool. Here I selected this shape, go to the reflect tool, and with my Alt key press, I'll click here over the path to set its reflection reference point. Choose vertical and then press copy. And there we have the other side drawn instantly. The options of flipping are also available up here in the control panel. You can set the reference point of the selected shape here and then use these commands. But as I have already mentioned in the previous video, flipping or reflecting or any kind of transforming from here is very limited as compared to directly using the transforming tools from here. So this is all about reflecting, and in the next video we will discuss about next type of transformation, which is scaling. Thanks for watching Night Graphics, and stay tuned for more upcoming tutorials by subscribing to this channel.